But we cannot win this battle. We cannot win this fight. Because the giants that are in the land were two men stood up for the word of God. Because they believed God. And God said they could conquer, and they believed it. God is saying to us as the church today, many were called, few were chosen. Many, Moses called 12 to go, but only two really understood the mission. The mission was to bring a report of the land that we must go through. Two brought a positive report. 10 brought a negative report. God is saying to the church, whatever you do, do it wholeheartedly. Do it with all your might. Be led by the Spirit of God. Be led by the Word of God.
Amen.
And let nothing or no one distract you from what God has placed in you. Let nobody hinder you from the mission for which God has sent you on. There were times in our lives that we have to stand against the crowds. But when we stand in Jesus, we're not alone. And God said, we must believe.
Amen.
And the word of God is saying, do it or not. Do it for the honor and for the glory of God.
Amen.
And I just want to remind you, the Lord knows that I have, the Lord of scriptures I have. This is where God wants me to say.
Alright,
amen. That's it. God is calling a people.
Right.
You don't have to go away and dream. You have to spend some time in heaven.
Oh, yes.
But this song is telling us, when we stand in that place where no man stands alone, take time to be holy.
Hey, glory.
Take time to speak off of the Lord.
Right.
And abide in Him always.
Right.
To feed on His word.
Make friends.
Then you must make friends of God's people.
Right.
Oh, that is the problem with us as Christians today. We want to be with the world. And if it comes to the time of the church, it will not be found. Make friends of God's people.
That's alright.
And in making friends with God's people, then you will find that God will continue to guide you in the earth. And He tells you, take time to be holy. The world rushes on. The world is not waiting for you, it's not waiting for you.
No, no.
The world will continue to be the world. But the church must be the church. You can't change the church and build the word. You can't take the word and bring it into the church. The church is the church. And I leave you with this. Joshua was a man called and sent by the people. We look at a scripture, and I'm going to read you this, and I'm going to sit down. We know very carefully that God said something about this man called Caleb. In the 24th verse of the 14th chapter, but my servant Caleb, because he had another spirit in him, which is the Spirit of God, paraphrasing, and had followed me fully, him will I bring into the land whereto he went, and his seed shall possess it. When you obey God, when you are directed by God, you will possess the land.
That's right.
Not only will you possess the land, but your children and your children's children will inherit the land. Because one word, obedience. When we obey God, the only way we can do that, we gotta take time to be holy.
Amen.
When we speak off with our Lord, therefore, Joshua was 40, Caleb was 40 years old in the mountain, and 45 years later, God brought it to pass. He was 85 years when he fulfilled that which God had promised to him. And he said, I am 85 years of age, but I feel like a man of 40. Brethren, beloved in Christ, whatever you do, do it wholeheartedly unto the Lord. It's a prayer. Forgive me.